Hey guys, welcome to another video. I'm really excited to show you the OnePlus 6 camera settings in this video. I've been testing this phone for a couple of days now and I'm really pumped with how the dual camera setup works and what are the settings that they have given is really impressive for what price you are paying. So this is not a review unit. Nobody has sent me to review and say some good things about this. I bought with my own money, spending 40,000 rupees for 8GB RAM and 128GB ROM. This is a mirror black finish version. And also one thing to note that I'm switching from Samsung to the OnePlus 6 now, and I'm really excited to test this as my daily driver. And stay tuned on my channel and stay subscribed so that you'll be knowing I'll be giving updates on this phone, how this is working and what are the things that you need to set up. So this video will be particularly about the camera setup, how you have to set different settings. I'll be sharing some tips and tricks as well, so come along with me, join me on this video and stay subscribed. Hit that like button if you really find this video helpful. So without wasting any more time, let's begin with the video. So guys, just as you open the camera interface, this will be the default camera interface on the OnePlus 6. Now you have plenty of options that you can be tweaking and you can get the pictures the way you want. So now first setting you have here is the option to turn on the flash manually. You can forcibly turn on the flash by tapping on here. If you don't want flash, unnecessary flash, sometimes the camera decides on itself and gives you that flash. If you don't want to do that, you just have to disable it this way. And the next one is the interesting thing. This is the 4:3 aspect ratio. Typically this 4:3 aspect ratio was found on older television setup and such things, but nowadays still they have kept this particular 4:3 aspect resolution. I don't know the real reason, but still if you just tap on that, you will get the 19:9 aspect ratio, which covers the entire screen, and you have the 1:1 aspect ratio. Now 1:1 aspect ratio is really important when you are particularly sharing the picture on the Instagram or some other social media, because you don't have to crop the pictures again and again. So that way it is really helpful. The second one is the 19:9, as the name suggests, as the number suggests, you get the full aspect ratio. Now why this is useful, helpful, is if you want to view the pictures on your screen itself in full detail, and 19:9 aspect ratio will be really helpful. One thing is missing here is the 16:9 aspect ratio. A lot of other phones give you that option particularly, but here it is not available, unfortunately. Hopefully if OnePlus sees this video and give you an update with 16:9 aspect ratio. Now you have the 19:9, and if you want to extract full resolution of this camera, full image quality, you have to click the pictures in the 4:3 aspect ratio, because if you click the pictures in 19:9 aspect ratio, there will be downgrade in the image size. It's one thing to note down. And another setting here is the obviously HDR. HDR is the high dynamic range. It covers a lot of bright light, and that is what we call the highlights, and lot of black colors, that is what we call the shadows. That means the highlights and the shadows will be compensated particularly, and it will give you a proper photo where it covers all the shades of light. That means whenever you have the foreground elements dark and only the background is properly lit, you can use the HDR to compensate the brightness of the picture, and then it will actually boost the shadows and give you the proper HDR pictures. So that is when it is really helpful. It is also helpful while you are capturing particular landscape pictures. It comes in handy. So to turn on the auto HDR, you have A here. If you want to forcibly turn on HDR, if you want always pictures to be HDR, you have to tap on this HDR. Otherwise you can disable the HDR as well. The next setting, as you can see here, is the timer. So 3 seconds, 5 seconds and 10 seconds timer is what the options are. So if you want to picture to be captured after 3 seconds, you tap on 3 seconds, then just press the shutter. After 3 seconds, boom, there you go, the picture is taken. So this much setting is available on the default mode here. So the next one you see the small little icon here is the 1x and 2x zoom. If you want to zoom down the pictures, you can do it twice. If you just hold on this, you will get up to 8x of digital zoom. I prefer and I suggest you that you use the zoom feature up to only 2x. Otherwise, it will get blurry because it just extracts the picture of the same resolution and zooms it for you. So there is no optical zoom. That's why up to 2x is feasible. So the pictures will come out good if you take in 2x zoom. So these are the settings available on the just normal default photo mode. Now if you want to bring the portrait mode, you just swipe left like this and here you go. All the features and settings are available here. If you want to capture video, just tap on this and here you see the 1080p resolution. Here you see the flash. Now if you want to change the resolution, just tap on this. Here you get 4K 60fps, 4K 1080p 60fps, 1080p and 720p. Now the great thing that OnePlus has given you is that you can actually capture 1080p 60fps with optical image stabilization. That means your pictures won't come shaky or wobbly kind of thing, but still you get the very stable shots even if you are capturing 1080p 60fps. And while you are capturing in 4K, this is the standard 4K 30fps, you have the electronic image stabilization working here as well. And 4K also gives you really smooth footage compared to other smartphones. That is the real advantage you have with the OnePlus 6 while you capture the video at 4K. So really impressive thing that OnePlus has given for this money. And 4K 60fps without any stabilization, your footage will be little bit on the shakier and wobblier side, depends on how you are capturing, how your hand is without shake. So that's these are the features available, and if you just tap on any of this thing, it will be set up here. Again, you can use the zoom mode here. 1x 2x digital zoom is what you can use. So this much feature is available on just video mode here, and we shall move to the portrait mode now. If you just tap on the portrait, you have the portrait mode where you can capture pictures with depth effect. Now you can really blur the background, but there is no control over how much you want to blur the background. The camera itself decides if you place something object like this here. So if I place my thumb like this, see, it is already detecting me that there is something object in front and it has to use the depth effect. So you can really see that here, that depth effect is enabled when it turns on green. So 0.3 to 2 meters is what they suggest, and the background will be completely blurred as you can see. And this is how you take the depth effect using the portrait mode. So if you take pictures of any persons, and if you just tap on this, there is a beauty mode enabled here. So just tap on this little icon to get that beauty mode while you capture the depth effect as well. So this is really nice and handy feature that I appreciate that they have given you in separate mode. And here, as you can see, there is small little icon here. If you just tap on this, you'll get the star, you have the heart mark here, you have the circle. So just some blurriness will be there when you capture pictures in portrait mode, and it will give you with that effect. So that's a nice thing available here as an extra feature, so you can utilize that. Another thing is the timer, 3 seconds, 5 seconds, 10 seconds for portrait mode. So this is the portrait, dedicated portrait mode on the rear camera of the OnePlus 6. Now if you just swipe left like this, as we have seen the video and photo and portrait mode, now we will move to the slow motion. So this is the slow motion mode only after the update this is available. If you have bought your phone very new, if you are just set up your phone, you just have to update, go to the system and update your mobile, and then this slow motion will be unlocked. So if you look on the left side here, you have the ability to capture 1080p at 240 frames per second and 720p at 480 frames per second, which is an awesome feature for this price point that they have given you a slow motion video, and yet you can select the two different resolutions. And for 1080p, you can capture up to 240 frames per second. So I'll be covering a lot of interesting videos about the slow motion, how you have to take the composition and do some tips and tricks as well. I'll be sharing that, so stay subscribed on my channel. And here, if I just swipe left again, you have the real pro mode here. This is what we are all interested in when using the OnePlus 6. So guys, the first thing you'll notice in the pro mode is this electro level meter, small little line over here. What this basically ensures you that how much it is level to the horizontal. So when you are compositing any picture, it becomes really important to use this electro level meter as a gauge, whatever you can call, pronounce it. Now it will ensure you that it is absolutely horizontal to the ground, and when you capture the picture, it will be really professional alike. So this way you can use this electro level meter, which is a nice feature. The next thing you are noticing here is the histogram. So there is a built-in histogram as well. It really shows you how much there is a shadows, how much there are highlights, and where your picture stands. Now this particular exposure compensation is what here it shows, and as you can see, there is a lot of shadows open and the highlights is not blown, so everything is in the middle, is in the right place. That means the exposure is absolutely perfect. So this way you can utilize the histogram as well. And if you just tap on this again, you can choose the aspect ratio of the image, 1:1, 19:9, 4:3. I've already explained that. There is the timer here. Again, you have the ability to capture RAW, which is awesome. I'll be testing in depth on how this RAW mode works and all. So stay tuned on my channel and stay subscribed, guys. So if you tap on this RAW, you can actually capture RAW and post edit the picture. So capturing RAW ensures that whatever the sensor is looking at the picture, all the information will be stored exactly without any post processing from the mobile itself, so that you get the pictures from the direct sensor, and later you can post edit while bringing some extra boost wherever you want. Now you can see that this scenario is perfect. We don't have to edit anything, but if you want to do any editing, I suggest you capture the pictures in RAW always, so that you have the flexibility and you have some room to edit the pictures really in your computer. So this is the RAW image, and the next one you see here is the custom mode C1, C2. This is what you find typically on DSLR cameras, that too on mid-range to costlier DSLR cameras, where you can actually set your own personal style from this setup to C1 and C2. So next time, whenever you just open the camera, you just can go to the C1 or C2 mode, and all the settings will be applied to that instantly, so that you don't have to again go through all the settings. So that's a really awesome feature. So these are the last five modes that we'll be looking in this video. This is the auto mode, where you can actually compensate the exposure. Say that you have some very dark elements in the foreground, you want to compensate that, you can just increase to plus 0.5 stop and get the extra brightness over the picture, and boom, there you have the beautiful looking picture. The next one is the focus, so you can manually focus. Sometimes if the camera starts to hunt, I did not find any issue with the camera focusing system, it really works properly, but still if you want to get that manual focus, it is always here. There is a flower mark here, meaning that this is the closest focus distance, and there is a landscape mark here, that means the focusing distance is up to infinity. So this way you can adjust manually. The next setting is the shutter speed. As you guys know, if I set 1:8000, 1:1000, so more the number, what this basically does is it will freeze the motion, it will freeze the action subjects and give you proper subjects. So if you are capturing sports photography, I suggest you use the custom shutter speed of whichever is proper to that situation, and then take the picture. So that way you can freeze the motion of the subject. So if you choose the shutter speed below 5 seconds, 10 seconds, or say 30 seconds, even 30 seconds, then you'll get very, very smooth, silky looking subjects. But make sure that you are holding the camera very steadily. That way you will ensure proper, sharper pictures. The next setting here is the white balance. Now in the outdoor situation, sometimes what happens is the camera sensor doesn't detect what the scenery is, and based on that, the white balance will be, the colors you are looking will be very changed. So what you can do is go to the white balance and just change the Kelvin. Now see how the colors is changing. It will show you live. And whenever you think this is the perfect color that you're looking for, just capture the picture, and boom, there you have it, proper color. The last one is the ISO. So ISO starts from all the way from 100 ISO, all the way it goes up to 3200 ISO. I recommend you leaving this ISO to auto always, because you don't want to get noisy pictures while setting the ISO to higher numbers. So that's why you leave it to auto. That works really fine on this camera. And if I just swipe left again, you have the time lapse. You can capture time lapse, amazing time lapses of cityscape or nature, and you have the last mode, which is panorama. Now panorama cannot be captured in a landscape way this way. You have to tilt the camera, you have to turn the camera like this and capture the panorama this way. So that's one thing to note there. So these are the camera settings that is available on the OnePlus 6. One last but not the least, if you just see the settings mark here, tap on that, and here you can see all the settings extra, where you can enable the GPS tag. If you want to store the location of the picture, you can do that by tapping on this. You have the shutter sound, you have the grid, you can bring the grid 3x3 grid, 4x4, which will help composite pictures very nicely. So there's a golden ratio here. And you have the rear camera beauty mode. If you want to apply facial beautification to the rear camera photos, I've already showed that where the beauty mode is in the portrait mode. You can enable it from here. You can use the watermark, tap on watermark and tap on this name, and you can give your own name on the powered by here. Whatever you give the name, you'll have that name shot on OnePlus by your name. So that way you can enable the watermark, which is a nice feature. And you have the invert photo. If you're taking selfie, the photo is flipped other way, you can use this invert mode. And there's save normal photo as a portrait mode. So if you don't want to apply bokeh effect, you can use this save normal photo. You can just enable it. There is a histogram enabled, horizontal reference line, that is what I called electro level meter. You can enable and disable from here. So these are the basically everything that I have shown here is pretty much that's it on this OnePlus 6. I think they have given you some awesome features, dedicated features to capture some great looking images. So dear friends, I hope this video was helpful. I think this video will be a little bit on the longer side, but still I have shown all the settings that is available on this OnePlus 6, all the settings that you need to know about the rear camera of this OnePlus 6. If this video helped you, then please like the video and share with your friends. Also stay subscribed on my channel, I'll be making a lot of interesting videos. So see you all in the next one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.